Oh boy. Hello. What's going on? Actually, oh.
Hello.
What is this?
Yeah. Hello to everyone coming in. Hello, hello, hello. I think you all may be familiar with who I'm drawing, or who I'm painting, I should say. One of the greatest anime characters and movies of all time. Of course, I have a type down there, so you should see it already. I'm going to do this with some watercolor and some marker. So I'm doing mixed media. I think I'm going to be doing prints of these. Yeah, I'm going to do prints of these right here. Hello. Hello, hello. Oops, excuse me. Hey. Hello. How are you? Hello. Good to see you. Good to see you. How have you been? I'm glad I can inspire you. Always glad I can inspire you. Let's do that. Okay. Now, did all that fun stuff. Now we gotta get to everything else. Now we're here to the markers. This will give me time for the watercolor paint to dry. It's one good thing about watercolor, it doesn't take long for it to dry. So, and the markings on her face. Oh boy. All right. And what else? What she did out here? She's dark brown hair. Don't mistake it for the black. It's dark brown. Hold on. Brown right there. Brush off some of that this wrinkled up piece of the paper and stuff. I used the watercolor paint because there's some shades of certain colors that I don't have in terms of markers. Otherwise, if I had all the colors that I actually wanted, that I actually needed for this, that give it the effect I wanted, I'd have just stuck with the watercolor. I was stuck with the markers, but since I don't, had to improvise. I don't have a color this light in markers, at least not yet. So I use some brown, orange, yellow, and white paint. Just give me the general colors, the specific colors, but it mixes them all together to get this particular shade. And then when it's a certain color that I already have that I could use, then I can go ahead. Like, I don't have a greatest light in terms of markers, so I gotta use some very, very diluted black for that. I gotta almost make it clear, almost water all the way, just so I can give it the tone of gray that I want. Because usually when you would have a shadow on a white surface, depending on what it is and how dark the shadow is or how strong the light source is, you know, it changes. But normally, if it's a white surface with a pretty high light source, it's either gonna be all white or it's gonna be some kind of shade of gray, a very light shade of gray. Okay. I mean, there are darker shades of gray, which I have and I'm going to use also, but now I'm using a lighter shade of brown, well, lighter than this shade, to address the light source coming from right to left. You can tell where all the shadows are laying. You can tell where the light source is. Shadows are always opposite of the light source. That's just a simple science. Shadows are always opposite of the light source. So wherever the shadow is, the light source is on the opposite direction. And then I'm going to go over this light brown with the darker brown that I have to just show the shadows, to show where some of the shadows lay. That's all. And then while this is dry now, I can go over this with also the brown. Like a darker shadow. Where all the shadows are. Because there are different types of shadows. They're not just, you know, it's light and it's dark. There are different types of shadows here. And different shadows have different names depending on how they fall on the subject. They have different names. This. I don't know what that was. So not all shadows are created equal. This is just her mouth. Like she doesn't wear lipstick and, you know, and anything like that. So usually with light skin or someone who's Caucasian, the lips are usually like a peach or a pink. So that's just that. Of course, can't forget her eyebrows. I'm gonna make the eyebrows a little lighter than her actual hair. And her eyes. And I'm get it with some pupils. Latin with four pupils. And you see she has a very stern look on her face. Like she means business. Not to be trifled with. Not to be played with. Oh, I almost forgot. People don't know. When you look at the eye is never really white. It's usually like a gray or something like that. But it's never truly white. There's always some shade of something. So depending on what it is. But this. And yellow. Or like the little edge right there. Marcus had time to dry, so I can go over that. Her mask is not like metal or anything, so. So shadows. And so the light source is here. And for the shadow of the mask, shadow here. Shadow here. So we already got a little shadow here. Turn it off, like, round it off right there. For the darker gray, use the marker for this. Fur right here, a little pelt, her fur pelt thing. Hello. It's like some little shadows and stuff on the fur, on the pelt. Thank you. Thank you very much. These little accents right here, just to give the pelt a little more depth. So I'm going to cut the background. Excuse me. What's... Yeah, I do that. Make this with the background dark purple. Well, a purple, better. With the ear, no way. Uh-oh. All right, a little more with the ear. There you go. All right. I think that's it. I think I'm done. Thank you all. Thank you all who came on and watched. Appreciate it. Oh, am I done? Actually, hold on. Let me do a little bit more. Hold on. Slow down. Something small, but I see it. Alright, there you go. It's small, but I see it. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoy it. I will catch you all later. Peace.